Hello, good morning student. I am Professor A.V. Brahmane. In this video, we will learn article number 5 in unit number 4. The name of the article is Minimum Execution Time and Minimum Cost Optimal Execution Time. Dear students, we are often interested in knowing how fast a problem can be solved or what the minimum possible execution time of a parallel algorithm is, provided that the number of processing elements is not a constraint. As we increase the number of processing elements for a given problem size, either the parallel runtime continues to decrease and asymptotically approach a minimum value, or it starts rising after attaining the minimum value. We can determine the minimum parallel runtime, TP min for a given W by differentiating the expression for TP with respect to P. No doubt that W is the work size. And equating the derivative to zero is differentiable with respect to P. The number of processing element for which TP is minimum is determined by following equation. Now see, dear student, we are interested in minimum time to solution. We can determine the minimum parallel runtime TP min for given W by differentiating the expression for TP with respect to P and equating it to zero. So D by DP, TP equal to zero as given in equation number 19. So let P0 be the value of number of processing element. The value of TP min can be determined by substituting the P0 for P in the expression for TP. In the following example, we derive the expression for TP min for problem of adding n numbers. So if P0 is the value of P as determined by this equation, TP of P0 is the minimum parallel time. Now consider the minimum execution time for adding n numbers. Okay, that is our very famous problem, minimum execution time for adding n numbers. So under the assumption, the parallel runtime for the problem of adding n numbers on P processing element can be approximately given by TP equal to n by P plus 2 log P. So this equal to is here. TP equal to n by P plus 2 log P. Executing the derivative with respect to P of the right hand side of this equation to 0, we get the solution for P as below. Okay, so finally we get TP equal to 2 log n. Okay, taking the derivative with respect to 0, we have P is equal to n by 2. The corresponding runtime, one may verify that this is the indeed a minimum by verifying that second derivative is positive. Note that at this point the formulation is not cost optimal. Okay, so now as shown in this equation or in the above example, let TP cost optimal be the minimum time in which the problem can be solved by cost optimal parallel system. From the discussion regarding the equivalence of cost optimality and ISO efficiency, we conclude that if the ISO efficiency function of parallel system is big O of f of p, then the problem of size W can be solved cost optimally if and only if W is equal to omega of f of p. Okay. So let TP cost optimal be the minimum cost optimal parallel time. If the ISO efficiency function of parallel system is big O of f of p, then the problem of size W can be solved cost optimally if and only if W is equal to omega of f of p. In other words, for cost optimality, P is equal to big O of f of minus 1 of W. So TP cost optimal can be given omega of W by f of minus 1 of W. For cost optimal system, TP of big O of W by P, therefore. So this is the minimum cost optimal parallel runtime. Now the one example is given here, that is again, consider the problem of adding n numbers. The ISO efficiency function f of p of this parallel system is big O of p log p. From this we have p is approximately equal to n by log n. So finally we get the cost optimal time for parallel system, tp cost optimal equal to log n plus log of n by log n, that is equal to 2 log n minus log n. So at this processor count, the parallel runtime is given by this equation tp. Okay, so asymptotic analysis of parallel program is explained here. Asymptotic analysis of parallel system. At this point, we accumulated an arsenal of powerful tools for quantifying the performance and scalability of the algorithm. Let us illustrate the use of this tool for evaluating the set of parallel programs for solving the given problem. Often we ignore the constant and concern ourselves with the asymptotic behavior of quantities. In many cases, this can yield a clearer picture of relative merits and demerits of various parallel programs. Okay, so comparison of four different algorithms for sorting a given list of numbers. The table shows the number of processing elements, parallel runtime, speedup, efficiency, and PTP product. Okay, so this is the asymptotic analysis of the parallel program shown in this table. If the metric is speed, the algorithm A1 is best, followed by A3, A4, and A2. So here A1, A2, A3, A4, these algorithms are shown. And if the metric is speed, then A1 is best, followed by A3, A4, A2. In terms of efficiency, A2 and A4 are the best, followed by A3 and A1. So if efficiency, we consider the efficiency, then no doubt about that, the A2 and A4 are best, followed by A3 and A4. In terms of cost algorithm, A2 and A4 are cost optimal and A1 and A3 are not. So if in terms of cost, you can see in terms of cost, that is a PTP. So A2 and A4 are cost optimal, A1 and A3 are not cost optimal. It is important to identify the objective of the analysis and to use the appropriate merits. So dear student, this is the end of this article, that is the minimum execution time and minimum cost optimal execution time. Along with that, we have seen the asymptotic analysis of parallel program. So student, this is the end of our article number 5, that is minimum execution time, minimum cost optimal time, and also 6, that is asymptotic analysis of parallel programs. In the next video, we will see other scalability metrics. Till then, thank you very much. Goodbye.